Hi, and welcome back to the Ucommerce training for Umbraco. In this video, I will talk a little bit about how the project structure in the Ucommerce training course is, and I will also talk a little bit about how you can work with Ucommerce and Umbraco in combination to build up your websites. I installed Ucommerce and Umbraco and the training material in the previous video, and in this video, I will sort of set up the first page and explain a little bit what's in the Visual Studio solution that we just installed before. So let's go over that. I have my site running right here. I just pressed F5 after I built my solution and everything is up and running. Ucommerce is installed up here to the right. And here I have my Visual Studio solution open with everything that needs to be there to complete the web shop we will build. We will take a classic MVC approach, which is how Umbraco works very well. It's important for me to say that this is just an example of how you can build a web shop using Umbraco and Ucommerce. Ucommerce will be flexible enough that you can apply your own best practices from Umbraco that you know and love. So if that's building up sites with a web API and front-end frameworks like Vue.js or React or whatever, then you can do that as well. Also, the content structure that we will be building in this training course is just an example of how it could look and feel. You can also build a single page checkout. You can do it however you want, and Ucommerce will be able to follow based on what your requirements are. With that out of the way, let's take a look at what the NuGet package we installed ships in our solution. So with Umbraco, it's a classic MVC approach in this case, which means that we have shipped a bunch of controllers, which will resolve to content pages in Umbraco based on the doc types. So these are shipped here, and the training course will take place down here in the controllers mainly. There's also some models and some views that we ship out of the box. We don't want to sit and fiddle with the HTML because that's not the scope of the Ucommerce training. But of course, if you're interested and you want to play around, you can just go ahead and edit those as well on the side. It's up to you. So the views are already built out for you. So we will be focusing primarily in the controllers. So that is when we need to do our product listing, then we find the appropriate controller that has already been shipped, and we will use the Ucommerce APIs in there. Good. It's also an important point in this video is that Ucommerce and Umbraco are two separate systems. We will be talking more about that later as well. And each has its own responsibility. We will not share responsibilities if we can avoid it. We want to enforce a best of breed approach, which means that whatever Umbraco does very well, we don't want to tamper with that. We don't want to enforce any other out of the box way that are not how Umbraco developers already know to work out with Umbraco. So we leave the responsibilities that Umbraco does great, which is handling content, handling media, handling items, content pages, users, members, all that good stuff. And then Ucommerce will enable the commerce APIs and save the commerce data in our own database. And that's basically also what you will learn throughout this training course, that whenever we build up a new page, it will partly be working in Umbraco, partly be working in Ucommerce. So let's try to set up the front page just so we can get an example of how that works. So we are ready to continue our journey. So I will only show this once, but every time we need to build up a new page, we do this exact same approach. There will be a controller associated with the page that we built, which means we will build a new doc type for every page. That can of course also be based on your own best practices. Again, this is just an example. So if you get stuck later on in the training course because you don't know how to proceed, because you don't have the page there, then you can go back and visit this page again. But this is sort of just Umbraco 101 in many ways. So we don't expect that this is very complex. All the fun parts will come later, of course. So here I still have my website. up and running, and I need to create a doc type so I can create my first homepage, and that's what we will be doing here. In this case, I will select a document type without a template, because it's the controller's job to figure out what is the view we want to render. We of course have all the controllers shipped already. So I want to find the associated controller, which in this case is home controller. And the way that Umbraco maps that is via using the name home. Leave out the controller part because that's sort of an MVC convention that you don't specify that. And in this case, I want to have it on the root of my website. So I tick this check mark here as well and save. All right. So now we have the doc type. Now we need to create the first page, which is our homepage. And here I just want to select the URL home. And let's try to visit the front page just to see that everything works. Basically, I just expect a complete empty website, which I have right now. And now we will start to fill in the blanks in some of the later exercises. This is actually the first example of when you build up a site with Umbraco and Ucommerce. Part of it is bootstrapping all the pages in Umbraco. You already know that. And then we will start to enable the Ucommerce APIs later on. And basically, that's it for this video. I hope to see you in the next one very soon.